obsessed with, and longtime fan, first time caller. basically, the other day at work, I'm an IT guy, and the other day at work, a bunch of people came up to me and they said, "Hey Jesse, the internet's broken." And I'm like, "Really?" And a lot of people were complaining because they couldn't access Wikipedia. I was trying to explain, this is an anti-SOPA movement that people don't want to, there's a law in Congress that would basically restrict the right, and basically make it so that, movie companies and record companies could just shut down things without judicial review. And, they already have tools like DMCA and things like that. And then I looked up that you're a co-sponsor of SOPA, and I was pretty shocked. So I just wanted to say I want to know why, and I hope you will stand up for no internet censorship, because this is a very important thing to me and my work, my life's work. So.
Some people who are just saying, "I want a free internet," one of the things they want is free movies and free music. And that is at least as popular as free pizza and free beer. And I am running for re-election. I'd like to be popular, but I can't be in favor of free pizza, free beer, and I'm not in favor of free music and free movies. What I am in favor of that this bill get properly tailored. The first thing is that the author of the bill has agreed that it applies only to foreign-based websites that are doing something that if they were US-based would already get them shut down. Now, I see a man shaking his head. SOPA as written now may fail that standard. I strongly support that being the first of many things to clean up the bill. We have a free and robust internet today. You're here trying to defend that robust internet. Nobody thinks that the fact that you can't have a free movie or stolen movie site operating here in the Valley, that's illegal now. That couldn't happen now. And a free and robust internet does not require free movies and free music to be available. What we don't want to have is sites shut down or unavailable because of, without judicial process, somebody just says, "Hey, there are a few bars of a song in the background of some YouTube offering." So the first thing that would help make sure this bill isn't overly expansive is to, by law, say this doesn't apply to any US-based site. So it doesn't apply to Wikipedia, it doesn't apply to YouTube, it doesn't apply. And then to go further and make sure that only sites that are dedicated to illegal file sharing or pirated movies and music are subject. There's a governmental review. This is not a circumstance where some executive at Disney wakes up, signs a letter, and a site is shut down or disappears from the internet or isn't searchable or whatever. So we need a better bill. We need, and the other congressman from the San Fernando Valley is, if you think I've taken a pro, he's for the bill without, as far as I know, without any changes at all. And I think that there need to be changes. But am I going to go, I speak at every high school in the Valley and say, free beer, free movies, free pizza? No. So if the bill can be tailored to meet its, and I think that on balance, it's going to be tailored to be under-inclusive rather than over-inclusive. And what I'm surprised at is that, not surprised, In this region, there are people on both sides of SOPA, because we've got a lot of people here who either work in the movie or music business, or they figure, hey, I own the restaurant in Burbank, and probably 5 or 10% of the people who come in do work in the movie or music business. For this bill to pass, we need the votes of people who don't have a movie job in their whole district. But every district has internet users. So I am very confident that this bill will be considerably narrowed before it is adopted. And I look forward to being part of that process. At the same time, I am not going to go to any high school and say I'm for free downloads of music and movies. That may be popular, but first of all, what happens to jobs in the Valley? And then second, what happens to the quality of movies and music? I mean, take it to an extreme. This file sharing could lead to a circumstance where every movie is just 90 minutes of product placement, because that's the only revenue stream available. So I think I've given you a fairly long answer.